He's a legend, of course, definitely. But folks, we have a very special guest joining us here at the desk of Great Day. We have Jerome Singleton here. He's a Paralympian, and he's going to be competing at the Drake Relays this week. So first of all, welcome to the program. Thank you for being here.
Yeah, really excited to be here today. It's really a blessing coming out here to Drake Relays to race tomorrow at 8. They're hosting a Paralympic event of a 200 meter. We all have disabilities, some blind, some single leg amputees, some double leg amputees, but we have like 4 of the 5 fastest in the world, so it's going to be a great competition.
That's pretty impressive.
They're all here, 4 of the 5 fastest.
Oh, yes, sir.
Wow.
Yes, sir.
Now, where'd you come from? This is your first visit to Des Moines, right?
Yes, sir. I actually came from South Carolina. Just moved up to Boston a little while ago, but I went home to South Carolina and spent some time with family. It got really cold, so I had to get out of there.
Yeah, right?
A little different. They haven't really had spring there yet, have they? Not so much.
Oh, not at all. Like, yeah. See, I used to be in Michigan, so I went to school up there, and it used to snow, like, over the months from, like, Thanksgiving to May.
Right.
But in Boston, 5 weeks. Yeah. 110 inches of snow.
There you go. Nice. So you went to school in Michigan. What did you study when you were up in Michigan?
Oh, I was a dual degree, actually. So I went to Morehouse College, studied math and applied physics, and then I went on to University of Michigan and studied industrial and operations engineering.
Jeez. Wow. Okay. Well, let's talk a little bit about your disability. So you have one leg, right, that you're... If we can have a peek at your special running leg.
Yeah,
here. This is absolutely
so cool.
Incredible.
Yeah.
So this is what you use when you run.
Oh, yes, ma'am. This is what I use when I run.
So what's the actual term for that right. Piece of equipment?
I said, this is my weapon. This is how I fight.
This is your weapon. Yeah.
No, but honestly, it's a running blade. That's what we call it.
Running blade.
It's an Oser cheetah foot.
Cheetah foot.
Got it. Look
extreme.
Underneath. I want to look at the bottom here. Now, this is the one you actually use?
Oh, yes, sir.
Okay, I want to show you something on the bottom here, which I was kind of surprised at. This looks like the majority of where the spikes are is all metal. I didn't realize that was the case. Is that normal, or is that just for this one?
Yeah, so with my running blade, I take a track spike, I cut it, and then I use some crepe and put the track spike on the bottom. So it's just like a able-bodied runner's shoe. I want to be consistent when I'm...
If we could ask, what happened when you were young that you lost the use of that part of your leg or lost that part?
So when I was born, I had a birth defect that caused me to get my foot amputated at 1.5.
Oh, okay.
I actually considered the best decision I never made, because I think when my parents made that decision, it gave me a chance to really, you know, become who I am. And they really pushed me to, you know, excel.
Yeah, you've been doing this, I imagine, at least as far as your competition, that goes back to 07, but I imagine since you were a kid.
I've been playing sports since I was a child. Mm-hmm. When I grew up, I was playing football, basketball.
Really?
I was actually one of the top 100 senior prospects coming out of South Carolina. Learned about Paralympics in 2000 and, let's say 2006. Mm-hmm. I was looking online and I saw a guy named Marlon Shirley. He was a 2-time Paralympic champion with one leg. I looked online and saw that the U.S. Paralympic Nationals were going to be in Atlanta, Georgia, and I was at Morehouse. Mm-hmm. So in my mind, I was like, I'm about to be the best in the world. I said, they heard that I was going to Morehouse, so that's why they had Nationals in Atlanta.
Down there, yeah.
But that year, I got cut from the team, but it showed me that Paralympic sport was a very high caliber of sport, had really good athletes, and if I did well, it really meant something.
Wow. You're most famous for beating Oster Pistorius in a race who's famous both for his ability and for what happened after the Olympics. Can you tell us a bit about that?
Man, we had a great rivalry. At least I call it a rivalry, but until 2011, I hadn't beaten him. Last time I checked, they called that a massacre. But it was always a great time. We've been racing for a while. It's been a blessing. Just going out there with the athletes, knowing that someone can come from, like, see, I was born this way, so mm-hmm. I was blessed to grow up this way and know what it is to overcome different challenges and obstacles. But for my competitors who may go through a traumatic injury, like, I have to tip my hat off to them, because instead of just sitting there and not doing anything with their life and having low expectations, they said, I'm going to go out there and really train and treat my body as well as possible. And we work hard. We put in a lot of time in order to be the best.
For as long as you've known, you've had to deal with this, so you really, I think you have a little bit of advantage over your competitors, which is good for you. You know, because this is your normal, isn't it?
Oh, yes, sir. It's so normal that when I go to sleep at night and I'm dreaming, I still got to put my leg on.
No way. Do you really?
Exactly, yeah.
Wow.
I'm like, man, Do I really know how my legs
are?
We have
to come out and watch you. Now, when are you running? Tell exactly what time you guys run.
Oh, so we race tomorrow at 8:08 in at the Drake Relays. Mm-hmm. It's going to be on Universal Sports. So if you can't get out there, make sure you watch.
You know that.
It's going to be fun.
Oh, that is so cool. So we're going to keep an eye on you and 8:08 tomorrow night, and you're going to love the Blue Oval. It's going to be very cool.
Yes, sir.
You're going to have a great time. Very nice to meet you, my friend.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Awesome. Good luck to you.
Thank you for coming to Des Moines.
Come back with a good medal.
Yes, sir.
That'll
yes,
work.
Sir.
It's 8:00. You're watching Great Day Live on